Now, the next section, medical terminology. I'm going to just go over really quickly because some feedback I got in the past blitz, which I'm going to take to heart, was the review is nice, but since we only have so much time, I would have rather that time be spent on more difficult concepts like E&M, etc. So I'm just going to breeze through these. You have the little sample questions in your handouts where you can see the answers. We talked about, you know, go to free online sources for flashcards and just get them under your belt if you don't know. And you're especially going to need to know it for when we move into ICD-10. ICD-10 is very heavy in needing anatomy knowledge, okay? We've got a medical terminology and anatomy course that we teach through, and I have brochures and business cards over there, through codingcertification.org. And it's made for coders. The book we use is made for coders. It's the only one. It just came out. It's called Medical Terminology and Anatomy for ICD-10 Coding. And it's really neat because it gives you a little preview of what's to come in ICD-10, but it helps you to understand anatomy and why you need to know all these nitty-gritty details, you know, for being a coder. You know, because it's like, we don't want to be nurses and doctors. We just want to code. But it's getting to the point where we really actually need to know anatomy almost as well in order to code it correctly. Okay, so I'm just going to breeze through these slides. There's 8 questions of medical terminology. Really know your word parts. Obviously, you can't memorize every single word in the dictionary, but if you learn that the suffix itis means inflammation, and you've got a medical terminology question that says, what's inflammation of the blah, blah, blah. Now, you might not know the root word for blah, 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 but you know the suffix for inflammation is itis. And there's only 2 answers that have itis on the end. So you know the other 2 are wrong. And you recognize one of the 2 that are left, and you know it's not that root word. Done. Process elimination.
Is there a solution to CPC exam overwhelm? You bet there is. Go to codingcertification.org and click on CPC review videos, where you'll learn how to pass the CPC exam on your very next try. Introducing the 2013 Medical Coding Certification Review Blitz videos. Over 13 hours of CPC exam review and CPC exam tips. Get an introduction to Lorian Yandrup's trademarked bubble and highlighting technique. Inside, 13 modules of video content to help you pass your next CPC exam. Available immediately via online access, with an option for in-home viewing on DVD. And get this, Coding Certification is now an approved AAPC provider. Get approved for CEU credits with an additional upgrade. Pass your CPC exam on your very next try. Click below now.